Welcome to the first of three short videos introducing you to development with Visual LANSA. LANSA's single skill set allows you to build applications for desktop, web, and mobile without needing to know any of the underlying technologies. Instead, a WYSIWYG designer and high-level language combined with LANSA's core repository and single-click compile will generate all of the code for you. The repository stores data definitions and their descriptions, validation rules, visualizations, multilingual text, and many more features. And of course, once defined, these features are available to every LANSA application you create. Over the next few minutes, I'll build this four-part browser application with a header, list, and editor, with data being supplied from the server database by a server module. The list of employees scrolls within its own bounds rather than scrolling the whole page, and the columns can be resized. Clicking an item in the list accesses the database and shows the details in the editor. Finally, when I resize, you'll see the application change to suit different device sizes. So I'll start LANSA's integrated development environment, and you'll be able to see how we could build this application without knowing any HTML, JavaScript, or CSS. I could start building the page immediately, but LANSA's modular approach allows me to build in pieces and to snap them together at a later time. So I'll start by making the web page header. For the moment, this will be a simple banner with a logo and title. The logo is stored as an image in the LANSA repository, and I'll use a label control with an appropriate caption. I'll then turn to LANSA's integrated theme features and select the title style for the header. I'll finish off by applying a layout to govern the size and position of the controls. This powerful feature means that when the application is resized, the LANSA runtime will do all of the hard work for you. Here I've aligned the logo and label center left, and they'll flow across to the right. Resizing in the editor shows how the header will appear at runtime. Before I go any further, I'll replace LANSA's rather dull default theme with one I prepared earlier. As soon as it's applied, you'll see the header adopt the new color scheme. You can, of course, make your own themes using your own colors, but for now I'll move on. With the header complete, I'll make the list with data drawn from the employee table. As I did with the header, I'll use a layout so that the list control will automatically fill the available space. I'll then go to the repository definition of the employee table and select the typical header fields such as identification number and name. When dropped, these will become the columns of data that the user will see at runtime. And of course, LANSA's WYSIWYG designer gives me complete control over the appearance. With the list complete, it's time to go to the server to get some data. To do this, I'll create a server module, which, as the name suggests, executes on the server. I'll specify the name of the table to be used and let LANSA generate some boilerplate code for me. This results in simple routines supporting the typical database activities. We'll see in part 2 how we can extend these routines to include additional tables and additional data, but for the moment the code that LANSA has generated is all that's required. I'll now return to the list and add some code to use the findAll routine that's just been generated. When the list is first created, I call the load routine, and the load routine executes findAll, filling the list with data. With the header, list, and server module complete, I'll start to construct the web page. I'll apply the theme, and as I've done before with the other parts, I'll define a layout. This will divide the page into two rows and two columns. I'll change the top row so that it has a fixed height. I'll also add a divider so that I can resize the columns at runtime. You'll now see the real power of LANSA's modular development. Simply by dragging and dropping the pieces that I've already made, I can construct a complex UI. The layouts defined for the parts means that they'll fit the available space, and the generated code in the server module is filling the list with data. With three of the four parts now complete, I'll finish off this first video by creating the editor. As I did with the header and list, I'll make another discrete part that I'll be able to snap into the application shortly. As before, I'll define a layout, this time splitting the part into two equal columns. You'll now see how LANSA gives you complete control when creating your design. The label now fits to the width of the column and has margins to the top, left, and right-hand sides. All that remains now for the subheading is to position the text within the label and to give it an appropriate caption. Then, with a single click in the theme, the subheading is complete and I can add the identification field. Thanks to the layout, the field is automatically positioned and I need only change the margins. I'll make a couple of changes to the field to remove the caption and make it a little bit taller. Copying and pasting the first subheading creates a second, complete with styling and layout. All I need do now is change the caption. I'll then return to the file definition to pick up the title, given name, and surname fields. The layout has done most of the work for me, positioning the fields correctly, so I need only change the margins and the height. As you've seen, LANSA's WYSIWYG designer takes the guesswork out of creating the UI, and as there's only so much dragging and dropping you can be expected to watch, I'll fade to black and we'll see the completed editor. With that done, I just need to add a little code so that when the application opens an employee, the editor loads the data from the server. This uses the find routine that was automatically generated for me when I made the server module. With the editor complete, I can return to the list part and add some code to handle a click event. Selecting the event from the list of available options inserts the code for me, and I'll now use LANSA's autocomplete features to help me complete my last remaining line of code. So now, when I click an item in the list, the application will open an employee using the current identification number. So that's everything done, with the exception of adding the editor to the page. And of course, that's just a drag and drop. And that's all there is to it. I'll let LANSA's single-click compile process generate some flawless HTML and JavaScript, and you'll be able to see the final result. And what you see is something with the look and feel of a desktop application, but running in a browser. Most importantly, this has been created in a point-and-click environment with a few lines of code and without any knowledge of HTML, JavaScript, or CSS. That's the end of part one. I'll be back with part two to show you how you can extend and maintain your applications with ease.